Cargo, the quest for gravity. I have played that game a long time ago on the channel and haven't touched it since, up until now, but I really should have, because Cargo is something else entirely. It is a game made by Russian developers Icepeak Lodge, who are some of my favorite video game developers at the moment, but usually their games are not exactly fun to play. Surreal and bizarre settings, pain-inducing survival mechanics, clever narratives and philosophical themes, these are the defining traits of their games. I guess someone in their team just went, fuck it, let's make a fun game for once. And man, they truly made a game about fun. In Cargo, the quest for gravity, you play as Phlox, an engineer intern who gets crash-landed on a strange island in a world where most of humanity have died out and some cruel robo-bucket-looking gods have removed most of Earth's gravity. I guess this game looks real deceiving. Judging from the visuals, it looks like a kid's game, but putting its plot into words, it sounds pretty ominous. What's even more ominous is that Cargo pretty much takes place in the same universe as The Void, a really bleak and mature game that takes place in an after-death limbo, where you struggle to even survive the entire time by collecting tiny leftovers of color in a black and white, mostly black, world, and have to fight grotesque creatures who came from an even scarier place. Cargo takes place in a higher plane of existence though, where color is aplenty. It's basically worthless, so to restore gravity you need to harvest pure fun from these little creatures called buddies. And holy shit, they're creepy. I'm sorry, they're actually the next step in human evolution. They're superior in almost all ways to humans. They are selfless, always trying to do good, and most importantly, they are aerodynamic. So they make for very good football balls. Even though they are superior to any of us, they mostly function as minions from Despicable Me in this game. But minions don't have shit on bodies. Their skin is ugly yellow color and they hide their genitalia-less bodies in jeans, while bodies run around completely nude. There is no shame when everyone looks like a fat baby with 40-year-old faces anyway. But anyway, the point of the game is to restore gravity to the Earth, and you do that by harvesting fun from buddies. And there are plenty of ways for doing that. You can kick them until they explode from fun. Exploding doesn't kill them, of course. Their bodies are superior to ours. If they explode, they just erupt from a volcano again. That's how babies are made. You can build all sorts of machines from scrap you find to drive bodies around until they explode. You can also throw rave parties on bodies live to rave. While they're dancing, the fun meter constantly goes up, allowing you to pull new floating islands and buildings from space, which result in more bodies inhabiting the place, which result in even larger rave parties, which result to pianos falling from the sky that you can throw into the sinkhole to summon even more bodies to the rave. So, infinite rave it is! Oh yeah, as you pull different objects to the orbit, the seasons start to change and you need different means of transportation for each season. The building system is fairly interesting in Cargo. You collect or buy any parts you need and can arrange them however you want. Or you can use pre-made blueprint if you're lazy and creative. The system might look a bit complicated at first, but it isn't at all, since there are not that many different parts to choose from. Similar building systems have been implemented in Robocraft or Crossout for comparison, but it looks like Cargo did it way ahead of those games. During the first season, you need to make a raft, because you need to cross the water surrounding every island. During winter, you need to make a land vehicle because the ocean has frozen. During spring, you need a submarine since the water level has risen from the melted ice and so on. It's pretty great. The sound design only adds to the weirdness of the game. Oh. Most of them are funny sounding voices that make you feel like you're constantly watched. And you are constantly watched by the gods you defy. The soundtrack is not necessarily the best I've heard, but some tracks are really memorable. Voice acting though?
Descend, you fool! Lower! Go lower, I say!
It wasn't bad, but it could be better. All in all, the game is pretty easy to pick up and play. It doesn't have a steep learning curve and harsh punishment for doing things wrong like other Icepeak Lodges games. The only thing you have to worry about is buddies dying. Yes, even though they are superior to humans, they're still not flawless. They might be immune to exploding from fun, but they're not immune to drowning, being hatched as eggs by birds, or being chopped into tiny little pieces. And about the last one, the buddies have some serious suicidal tendencies. They just find the act fun. I said it's not just a simple kids game. Of course, God did come up with a solution to that and made an actual Ubermensch.
Behold, the Ubermensch.
But we didn't talk about that. In fact, I should stop talking completely soon. Is it worth playing Cargo? Sure, it might have a couple of bugs and a little wonky controls, but it's a weird game that doesn't require too much effort to get through, and it's pretty short. At the very least, you'll have some pure distilled fun. Oh, and I've been afraid of this part, but I always select some music album that fits the reviewed game, since I am a big music nerd as well, and Cargo is quite the extravagant piece of work. But you know what? Screw it. Cloud Core. Toilet. Have fun. Bye.